Karnataka as a state is well known for its folk arts and handicrafts. Since the reign of the Cholas, Pallavas and Rashtrakutas, artisans have mastered the art of stone sculpting and have given the state a unique identity in the country's art and cultural scene. Close to the state's capital, away from the flurry of modern world, lies Shivarapatna, more commonly known as the Stone Village, where time has stood still for decades. This picturesque village seems to be slowly but surely witnessing winds of change, with the centuries-old stone sculpting tradition in danger of being wiped out. For the 300-odd families who reside in the village, stone sculpting has been a tradition that has been handed down from generations of skilled sculptors who have encouraged their sons to tread the same path. The sculptors here are said to be the descendants of the master craftsmen who built the world-famous Belur, Halebid, and Hampi temples. All male members of the family practice this art form. Endless hours of work has made these sculptors masters of the craft, producing sculptures that are in demand, not just in the state, but also on a national and international level. The entire process of sculpting designs out of simple stone is fascinating to behold. Using nothing but a hammer and a chisel, these artisans chip intricate designs, which has enthralled many an art lover. The process of creating these sculptures is no mean task. It takes months of patience, hard work, and dedication to produce a single piece of this breathtaking work of art. Artists mainly use two kinds of stones, limestone and black granite. Once the rock is broken down into smaller portions, a rough shape is given to it. Then, according to the sketch of how the final product should look like, finer aspects of the figure are worked out. Once the stone begins to take shape, the rough edges are smoothened and then the more intricate designs are carved. Apart from stone, artisans here also specialize in metal sculptures. For example, Veerabhadracharya and his family specialize in making solid figures. The first step is to make a vague form with clay and then coat it with wax to give it a more refined structure. Molten metal is poured on it and allowed to cool down, forming a more rigid shape. The large number of deities indicate that the bulk of the sculpting done in Shivarapatna is for temples. A 3-foot stone sculpture takes about 3 to 4 months of intensive focus and hard work to complete. The populace of Shivarapatna has been relying only on this profession for their livelihood for centuries. But now, their very existence is being threatened. Although old customers still throng to the village for the superior quality and intricate design of the sculptures, the profit margins of these poor sculptors has been dwindling over the last few years. In face of increasing economic adversity and government interference, the artists now have to resort to cost-cutting methods like using the Mysore stone in place of the black granite, compromising their traditional art values. When we spoke to an artist, Purushottamacharya, he lamented over the commercialization of the art that has been held sacred in his family for generations. Shivarapatna has been given the heritage village status, and although this seems to be a positive development for the stone village outwardly, a small discussion with the artists reveal how all is not well here. The project seems to limit their creativity and is imposing them to carry out their work according to the wishes of a few of those who sit in the confines of their urban setup and frame rules for these stone wizards.
We only want to survive in this village. We want our children to have a bright future. We will lose our creative freedom if we work under other people.
The local artisans complain that the state government, in collaboration with Kaveri Works Emporium, purchase these sculptures at almost half the price, but sell them in a grander setup which garners a price 2 or 3 times higher.
We sell our sculptures to the Heritage Village Board for 3,000 or 4,000 rupees. The board then sells them for 8,000 rupees, sometimes 15,000.
Those in the power corridors seem least interested in making lives of these artists any easier. The living conditions in the stone village are dismal, and the hope amongst the villagers that the government will support them in any way is bleak. The local MLA had promised the artists 24 hours of electricity supply, but the ground reality here shows that the villagers are given only 3 hours of electricity in a day.
The government has not provided us with basic amenities. Yediyurappa's government has promised to help improve the situation here, but nothing has happened so far.
The escalating prices are making matters worse. One truckload of limestone would cost about 30 to 40,000 rupees only a few years ago. But now, the artists have to shell out close to 80,000 rupees per load. The transportation has become more expensive as the fuel prices have skyrocketed and the government has started levying steeper road taxes, tolls and excise charges.
We have to pay tax, give bonus to our employees, and the material and transportation prices have gone up too. The government is proud of Shivarapatna, but is doing nothing to improve the situation.
The Heritage Village Board conveniently turns a blind eye to the artists' problems and gives a deaf ear to their cries. The board chooses to concentrate on the more cosmetic aspects of development. The artists of Shivarapatna are proud of their heritage and hope that their sons ensure that this inheritance is passed on for many more generations to come. But the situation today forces them to believe that there might be no stable future in this line of work, which has been the center of their universe. The growing disparity in the economic situation of the urban and the rural has further left the artists in the lurch. On one side, they are striving to hang on to the legacy handed down to them, and on the other, they are fighting to make their ends meet.
We have to pay a certain percentage of our profits to the government and pay taxes. The government does not give us a loan.
The once proud inheritors of a rich legacy, who breathed life into stones which narrated tales, are now reduced to contract laborers. Their outcry is unheard by our mighty policy makers. The state government, in this budget, has allotted a huge sum of money to boost tourism in Karnataka. If Shivarapatna, which is the only place in the country with Heritage Sculpture Village tag, is overlooked, it will not only be a loss to the artists here, but also a grave irreverence to the magnificent art of stone sculpting. What the artists of Shivarapatna need is not empty promises, but quick action. Otherwise, it won't be long before the sounds of the stone village are silenced forever.